بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده، نصر عبده وعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده، والصلاة والسلام على نبي من لا نبي بعده، والحمد لله الذي هو حق من ذكر وحق من عبد وأنصر من ابتغي وأرحف من ملك وأجود من سئل وأحسن من أعطى، هو الملك لا شريك له والفرد لا ند له، كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه، لن يطاع إلا بإذنه ولن يعصى إلا بعلمه، يطاع فيشكر ويعصى فيغفر، أقرب شهيد وأدنى حفيظ، حال دون النفوس، أخذ بالنواصي كتب الآثار ونسخ الآجال، القلوب له مفضية والسر عنده علانية، الحلال ما أحل والحرام ما حرم والدين ما شرع والأمر ما قضى، الخلق خلق والعبد عبد وهو الله الرؤوف الرحيم. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمد عبده ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه ومن سار على نهجه وتمسك بسنته إلى يوم القيامة. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. وقال النبي صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وسلم: الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت، والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله الأماني، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. Honorable elders, respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Indeed, it is indeed a great blessing of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a favor upon us all that He has enabled you and I to be from those who are here today and who are among those who are saying لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك، إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. Indeed, our father Adam alayhi salatu wa salam built the Kaaba, and thereafter Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, he made the call, and with the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he built the Kaaba and he made a call, and anyone who comes subhanallah answering the call of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, we are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the depths of our heart, and we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who are thankful and from those who on this day answer and get our sins forgiven, and from those who on this day turn to Allah and repent sincerely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا. O you who believe, sincerely repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Turn to Allah, turn to Allah. You will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most forgiving, the one who wants to answer your call, the one who is waiting for you, the one who wants to turn all of your bad deeds into good deeds. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you this opportunity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who make the most of this opportunity today, inshaAllah. Respected brothers and elders, dear sisters in Islam, Allah says in the Quran, هَلْ أَتَاهَا الْإِنْسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٍ مَذْكُورًا. Does mankind remember a time when he did not exist, when nothing existed? إِنَّا خَلَقْنَا الْإِنْسَانَ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ أَمْشَاجٍ نَبْتَلِيهِ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. Allah says, we created mankind in a beautiful way, subhanallah. هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ, and we guided mankind. إِمَّا شَكَرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. Either he is grateful, he is obedient, or either he is disobedient, and he is ungrateful. My dear friends, respected brothers and elders, just as before anything existed, Allah existed, a time will come when nothing will cease to exist, and only Allah exists, and Allah will exist, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will initiate the resurrection. As we are dressed in two cloaks today, and we are gathered in this place in Arafah, let us remember one thing, that inshaAllah, a time is coming when we will again stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah said, When a disbeliever will open the book, he will say, everything is here present. Every single deity he presents. And Allah will not oppress anyone. Respected brothers, elders, and sisters, Allah has sent us in this world for a purpose, and that is to earn His pleasure to please Him. That is to earn His pleasure to please Him. Shaitan is there to distract us, dissuade us, and to turn us away from the reality. Imam Ghazali rahimahullah is a beautiful example. He said the example of this world is the example of a man in a jungle, and he's running, subhanAllah. And all of a sudden, a lion appears here. And the lion has run to the entrance. And the lion makes an effort to try and get him. Now he's running. He's trying to escape from the lion, looking for some place of refuge. And what does he see? He sees a well. So he jumps out the well. When he jumps out the well, there's a rope. So he holds up to the rope. And he breathes a sigh. I'm safe. And then he looks up, he sees the lion trying to get him. When he looks down, rather than seeing water, he sees a snake. And the serpent has its mouth open, waiting for him. And on the rope now, subhanAllah, he's just holding on for dear life. On top of the rope, there's a black mouse, and there's a white mouse. And both mice are nibbling around at the rope, and skinnier, and it's just a matter of time. And in this whole situation, in front of him, he sees honey, and sweet, trickling honey coming down. He takes his finger, and he puts the honey on his finger, and he puts it in his mouth, on his lips, and he says, how sweet is this honey? And the honey makes it forget about the lion on track. The honey makes it forget about the flipper at the bottom, and the honey makes it forget about the two mice. Imam Ghazali the lion is your death, it's chasing after you, the serpent is your grave, it is waiting for you, the rope is your life, the black mouse denotes the night, and the white mouse denotes the day. So day at night, your life is getting shorter and shorter, and the honey of the sweetness is the dunya and the deception. It makes you forget about May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you and I from those who utilize these words we have today.